Donald Trump's lawyer submitted a 21-page filing to court yesterday, trying to convince the judge that this investigation has just totally, in their words, spiraled out of control. And they would like the judge to just rein it in a little bit. Now, what they're specifically asking the judge to do is to not lift the order that says the DOJ cannot go through the documents before the special master is officially appointed. The DOJ, of course, had argued to the court prior to the Trump lawyer filing that we need to kind of continue our job here. We've got a lot going on and we need to get busy with it. And of course, they had a lot of actually really good legal arguments in there, but that doesn't matter when you're up against a Trump-appointed judge. But it was the filing from the Trump lawyers, right, that caught everybody's attention because, again, these are lawyers that are basically whining to the court saying, we can't handle this. We don't know what we're doing. So let me read this from their filing. This investigation of the 45th president of the United States is both unprecedented and misguided. In what at its core is a document storage dispute that has spiraled out of control, the government wrongfully seeks to criminalize the possession by the 45th president of his own presidential and personal records. So what they're saying there is, one, he's breaking the law. Because this is the thing that these people, I don't know if they don't know it or if they just refuse to accept it, classified or not classified, that is totally irrelevant to the point here. Trump is legally not allowed to have the documents. So even if we weren't dealing with potential violations of the Espionage Act, we're still dealing with violations of the Presidential Records Act, which of course carries a penalty that includes the complete barring from ever holding public office here in the United States again. Not exactly a winning argument to go to the judge and say, yeah, he has these things, but really, y'all are just mad at how he stored them. No, we're mad that he had them in the first place because that is illegal. That's the illegal part. The Espionage Act part actually came later when we learned the documents were classified. Prior to that, it was strictly a violation of the Presidential Records Act, at least that we, the public, knew of. So you don't get to sit there, actually, maybe you do, because this is not helping your case at all, and argue that, yes, he had them, and he's allowed to have them. No. No, there is no universe under which he is allowed to have these things, whether or not he classified them, whether or not he thought they were his personal items. They were covered by the Presidential Records Act, and therefore they belong in the National Archives, and only in the National Archives. But I do love that they're using this kind of language, right? It's spiraling out of control. What they're really trying to tell the judge is, look, we don't know what the hell we're doing. We're in over our heads. This shit is spiraling out of control for us. Because it really is. We're talking about a gaggle of lawyers whose biggest legal achievement, Alina Haba, was serving as the general counsel for a parking garage company. So you're a parking lawyer. Christina Bob came straight from One America News Network, right? Like, you couldn't even make it on one of the real conservative networks. You had to go over to the Looney Tunes one, and now you're Donald Trump's lawyer. That's probably not good. Evan Corcoran, of course, does have real legal experience, but he also has another lawyer from Florida who also has basically no real criminal defense experience on her resume whatsoever. So you do have lawyers that obviously would look at this and say, yes, it's spiraling out of control, because that's what tends to happen when you have a legal team that has no earthly clue what they're doing. Warm weather is still here, and for me, that means hot, sleepless nights. I recently found a way to stay cool at night, which means I can finally sleep through the night. And since I started using Miracle Brand self-cooling bed sheets, I stay comfortable all night long. And did you know that traditional bed sheets can harbor more bacteria than a toilet seat? It can lead to acne, allergies, and stuffy noses, and it's just gross. Miracle Brand offers a whole line of self-cleaning, eco-friendly bedding, such as sheets, pillowcases, and comforters that prevent 99% of bacteria and require 3 times less laundry. Using silver-infused fabrics originally developed by NASA, Miracle Brand sheets are thermoregulating and designed to keep you at the perfect temperature all night long, so you get better sleep every night. These sheets are infused with natural silver that prevent 99.9% of bacterial growth, leaving them to stay cleaner and fresh 3 times longer than other sheets. No more gross odors. Miracle sheets are luxuriously comfortable without the high price tag of other luxury brands. The sheets use a premium 500 thread count sateen weave that's made with USA grown Supima cotton, which is one of the highest quality cottons in the world. And it's better for your skin. Stop sleeping on bacteria. Clean sheets means less bacteria to clog your pores and fewer breakouts and other skin problems. Go to trymiracle.com/ROF to try it today. And we've got a special deal for our viewers. Be sure to use our promo code ROF at checkout to save 40% and get 3 free towels. And Miracle is so confident in their product, it's back with a 30-day money-back guarantee. So if you aren't 100% satisfied, you'll get a full refund. Upgrade your sleep with Miracle Brand. Go to trymiracle.com/ROF and use the code ROF to claim your free 3-piece towel set and save 40% off. Again, that's trymiracle.com/ROF.